gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here. Today, I would like to talk on beneath our feet, the crisis of soil degradation. Most of you must be seeing soil, most of you must be seeing the soil every day, but may not be knowing much about the soil. Today, I would like to tell you something about soils. Soil is the cornerstone of life on earth. It is not dirt. It is the cradle of civilization, bedrock of our food system. And soil quietly cleans water and stores carbon. Our Veda says that soil is goddess. We call Bhumata, Bhudevi. And this Bhudevi is being degraded. So this is the time for us to take care of our Bhudevi. What are the reasons for degradation? It is human activity which is the main responsible for the degradation. They are the main culprits. That is deforestation, industrialization, civil urbanization, mining. These things are taking their toll on soil. More than this, indiscriminate application of fertilizers, pesticides, herbicides are causing major damage to the soil. The impact, the consequences of soil damage. The soil damage is a serious problem if it is continued continuously, if the same thing continues for years together. Our soils will become lifeless. And there is no surprise, even 40, 50 years, if it is continued, soils will turn into deserts. With this, the soil yields will come down, and human health is damaged. Malnutrition and carbon dioxide emission, a lot of carbon dioxide has been let out from the degradation of soil. And soil will lose their soil flora and fauna. Organic carbon percentage will be lost. And water holding capacity of soil will be depleted. With the depletion of water holding capacity, water will not be available. I will give you a small example for this. About 30 years back, when you wanted to water from bores in Hyderabad, you used to get around 300 to 400 feet, you used to get water. Now, if you want water in Hyderabad, you need to drill for 1,200 to 1,500 feet. This is a clear example. Everybody should know about this. And because of this soil degradation, biodiversity and ecosystem is also get damaged. This soil degradation is not the problem of India. It is a global problem. Throughout the globe, every country is facing the soil degradation problem, starting from rolling hills of Europe to plain lands of Africa and rainforests of South America to arid lands of Australia. Every country is having the same problem. Every country is facing this degradation problem. Regarding India, Green Revolution in 1960 has given boost for our crop production, and it made India self-sufficient. But the consequences are, with this, initially farmers were not interested even to apply one bag of fertilizer, one spray of pesticide. But in course of time, farmers started applying 15 to 50 bags per acre and 10 to 40 sprays per acre depending on the crop. In spite of applying 30, 40 bags per acre, farmers are not in a position to increase their yields. There are cases where yields were reduced. Initially, when pesticides were introduced, there are only two molecules available in India. But today, we are having more than 500 molecules. And in spite of having 500 molecules, farmers are not able to control their pest attack. It was a very severe, and they were not, because the main reason for they could not control is plants are losing immunity. I will give a small example for this. See, when we got COVID, everybody started taking zinc, zinc, zinc. But initially, where we used to get zinc? We used to get zinc from the plants. But today, unfortunately, zinc plants are not able to get zinc from the soil. And our soil is facing zinc deficiency. Unfortunately, we are giving zinc to the soil. Instead of taking from soil, we are giving zinc sulfate, we are giving zinc chelated zinc to address the zinc deficiency in the soils. This is a very serious problem. So, whereas in America or European countries, they have already realized the serious problem. They started reducing the fertilizer application and pesticides application. So this degradation problem is a serious one. But there is one thing I would like to tell you here. If it is the cancer in the first stage, you cannot cure. But if it is in the first and second stage, we can definitely cure. Here, the same thing happens. The soil degradation is only in the first, second stage. There is every possibility that we can cure this. We can definitely address this problem. Only thing, we should have determination to address this problem. So the main way to address this problem is initially drastically reduce the application of fertilizers and pesticides. That should be our primary rest point. Next, go for integrated nutrient management or integrated pest management. In this integrated nutrient or pest management, you need to give a lot of organic manure, biofertilizers, microbial products, microbial pesticides, microbial fertilizers to the soils, and limited quantity of chemical fertilizers and pesticides should be used, very limited quantity. If we continue this process, we don't get results overnight, but in a course of 1 or 2 years, 2 to 3 years, definitely soil will get back its lost organic carbon, and soil flora and fauna will be revived, and water holding capacity of the soil will definitely improve. So this is the need of the hour. We need to follow this. And a lot of new technologies have come. Precision agriculture, drones, satellite technology, sensors, artificial intelligence. All these things are in the initial stages. It is too early and to talk about those new technologies which are being adopted in the agriculture. At least unless we see about 4 or 5 years, we cannot assess the new technologies which are whether useful or which can address the soil degradation. So it takes time, so we need not discuss much about this new technology which are there. But the real problem which we are going to see, the challenge of the agriculture, is to face the increasing population in the world. The population is growing day by day. By 2050, we need to feed minimum 10 billion people every day. So this is going to be the problem. With this soils, can we do it? Definitely not. Now, need of the hour is to improve the soil health, overcome the soil degradation. Unless we address these two things, we will not be in a position to fulfill our target of 2050, because the land size is coming down day by day because the urbanization is increasing. So we need to give the healthy food to the human beings. For giving healthy food, we need to have healthy soil. So we should give prompt response to the soils. We should give high priority to the soils. We should not neglect the soils. We should take care of the soils. So our voice should be to protect our soil. And we should be the stewards for our soil. We should be the champions for healthy soil and champions for healthy food. So I request everybody to support this. Support, support, support. I hope everybody will support this. Protect your soil today for our soil, for our children tomorrow. Protect your soil today for our children tomorrow. This should be our slogan. Thank you very much.